Hi guys, I'm Dave Chesson of Kindlepreneur, and in today's video, I'm gonna teach you all about incognito mode, how it can help you with your Amazon research, and how to actually do it. So stay tuned. Did you know that every time you go to just about any website, that website's probably putting a cookie on your computer? And no, I don't mean the delicious kind, but more or less something that's helping them to track to see what you're doing. Well, Amazon is definitely guilty of doing this because what they like to do is they like to understand how you as a shopper use their website, how you search for things, and how they can better make the right product show in front of you. Now, while this is great and altruistic, the problem though is that, well, when we're trying to figure out what the rest of the market is doing, we don't want Amazon using our own information, and that's where something called Google Chrome's incognito mode will help. All you have to do is initiate the incognito mode when doing your Google Chrome browser, and it will stop. It will kind of hi-ya and chop off the cookies, make them not show up. It will also make sure that you're not logged into Amazon so that Amazon can't use your previous shopping data. Basically, it makes you a complete no-name to Amazon, and they have nothing to offer except for raw data. And that's what we want when we're looking for things like what people are searching for on Amazon, what keywords we should target, and anything else. So now that we know why we should do it and how it helps us as authors, let's go ahead and jump and talk about how you can actually quickly set it up so that the next time you do a search, Amazon won't know who you are. Using incognito mode when searching the internet is very simple. If you have Google Chrome, all you have to do is find the application, right-click it, and click Open New Incognito Mode Window. Now we know that we're in the incognito mode window because we can see this spy-looking guy right here in the middle, as well as in the top right corner. Now, if you are on a PC, all you have to do is find your Chrome icon, right-click it, and select incognito mode. Another way to use incognito mode is that if you're doing your regular Google Chrome searching, first off, you'll notice that you're doing that because it'll actually have this person here instead of that secret spy looking one. And if you're logged into your Google account, you'll see your Google information show up there as well. However, though, if you want to go to Google Chrome's incognito mode, all you have to do is go up to the file and select New Incognito Window. And now, just like that, we can go to places like Amazon.com and know that Amazon is not using previous searches of ours, our cookies, our account information, what we've purchased. We know that they're giving us the raw information right there without any of the other stuff, and we can get better data and make better decisions as authors. So there you have it. Just like that, you can make it so Amazon, Google, or any of them won't know who you are, so that you're not getting attached with cookies or tracked or followed or anything like that. And now you can get the raw data when doing your research, knowing that they're not using previous information about you to give you the right results. I'm Dave Chesson of Kindlepreneur, hoping to help you guys as you start doing your internet marketing and searches, as well as doing your research. So, if you like this video or you would like to learn more about book marketing, just go ahead and click the subscribe button that's listed on this YouTube page, and you will make sure to get the best of what I have immediately as it comes out. And with that, I'm Dave Chesson, signing off, saying thanks for being here, and you rock. Cheers.